Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this session, I'm going to talk about Snowflake Schema. Till now in this channel, or anyone who teaches Power BI talked about Snowflake Schema and its importance. But we have missed one of the important concepts, or this is another kind of modeling exists in Power BI or in case of data warehousing design. What it is, whether we need to use as part of Power BI or not, let us try to understand as part of this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. Let's try to understand star schema. Basically, your transaction or fact related table should be present in the center and your dimension connected directly, right, into your fact table. This is what star schema, because the structure looks like a star. So if you haven't watched my video, just watch it. What is star schema, when, why you need to build it, what is the advantage of it, right? So you can understand how you can build star schema. But today's topic speaks about Snowflake schema. What it is? Basically, a Snowflake dimension is set of normalized tables for a single business entity. What do you mean by normalized? If you ask me normalized, the definition is a little confusing here. Let me read through it. Normalization is the term used to describe data that is stored in a way that reduces repetitious data. Basically, what it needs to, in simpler term, I can say like normalization is a process of reducing duplication. That's it. Okay. So what do you mean by that? If you are a little bit confused about these definitions, let me try to explain. Assume this is your fact table. You have order number, order date, product key, that is product related information present in your fact table itself. Like over here, product key, let's say 594, it's mountain 500, which is repeating, right? Instead of having, you see, for 594, you have product, category, color, size, everything is repeated whenever that particular 594 has been purchased. You see mountain 400, mountain 500, silver, something like that, right? So all these things are called as repetition or duplication. Avoiding such repetition or duplication, like you keep all the related items of the product key into another separate table, then keep only the product key. This way you are reducing the size of this fact table, like over here. So when you remove this repeated columns, the related columns of the product, and keep it in separate product table and only keep product key in your fact, this is called normalization. Okay, but here it says, what about the category and subcategory if it introduced, right? So even if you move this product, category, color, you assume you have subcategory also, again these bikes, every, this also repeating. Further, you want to normalize. What I'm trying to say, assume this is your fact, you removed your fact related, I mean product related attributes into dimension, this becomes your star schema. Further, that subcategory and category also normalized, you remove duplicates. How it is, it will be looked like this. You have product subcategory here, key, and the subcategory description will be maintained here. Again, you have a product category key here, and product category descriptions will be maintained separate table. If you maintain like this, you are normalizing the dimension table, right? Now you read this definition. A Snowflake dimension is set of normalized tables for a single business entity. The business entity is about product. Normalization is a term used to describe that data stored in a way that reduces repetition of data. So now when you maintain the data like this, you are not repeating these items anywhere. Okay, that is why it is called Snowflake schema. Basically, you build a star schema that is one dimension directly related, but you see this can be subcategory and category that is indirectly related to your fact table. This is what a Snowflake schema is all about. Whether we need to decide whether we need to use Snowflake schema as part of the Power BI or not, right? Let's try to see it. The Microsoft recommendation, because the how Power BI works is based on the columnar database, it recommends you to avoid Snowflake schema. Why? Because Power BI loads more table, which is less efficient for storage. Longer the relationship filter propagation, meaning like if something is filtered here, it has to propagate through 1, 2, and then it reaches the third table. So the longer the relationship, okay, the filter propagation is more. The field span represents more model tables, because if you field span means while you are designing your reports, you see a lot of 4 to 5 tables for a single entity called product, right? Product, product category, subcategories that will create, but it is basically, it is not a major concern, but basically it is like a usability wise, it is drawback. And one more important point is like, you cannot create a hierarchy that spans the tables, because if you can create a hierarchy within a same table only, okay, because you can create a category and subcategory and product together, right? You can explicitly create a hierarchy, but people never bothered, because in the charts or some tables, if they drag and drop, that will be acting as a hierarchy. But in sometimes you need to explicitly create a hierarchy. Those is not, that future is not possible if you have a Snowflake schema. So to conclude, like, for Power BI design perspective, the Snowflake is not optimal. In some cases, in data warehousing design, to have a optimal storage of your data, right? In those cases, people go for Snowflake, but while reporting, they will combine and create a virtual table or views, combining all these three tables into single view or materialized table and acting as a star schema. So this is how people will decide. Let's try to check it out how it looks in Power BI. Now you can see this is the AdventureWorks database. This is my fact. These are other dimensions, but our focus on product. Now you can see this product has all its properties. Let me zoom in slightly. So product is connected to fact table. The product is filtering the fact table, but this product is in turn filtered by subcategory. And this subcategory in turn filtered by category. You see the propagation of the arrow here. It is from category to subcategory, subcategory to product, and from product to fact. So this is how, even this is allowed in Power BI. It is not, Microsoft doesn't recommend. It is not like you can only do this task schema in Power BI. You can still go for Snowflake schema, but when you compare the model performance with the star schema with the Snowflake schema, the star schema wins always. That is what the conclusion is. I hope you enjoy this video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.